Hello, today we're looking at something very exciting, something I thought would never happen, and it is Solus 3.9.9.9 brought out a KDE Plasma version based on the latest release, and that shocked me because I always thought that Solus is with GNOME, and GNOME have the, and the Solus edition got the Brisk menu, which the Mate version also have, which they use, so I saw the connection there, and because they have a, the Solus Bachi version, which I meant Solus at the beginning, is based on GNOME, and that's why they got the GNOME edition also, so I kind of saw how they all fit together, but then, yesterday, they produced the KDE Plasma version, and it's still in development phase, so it's version 1. So there is a few bugs here and there and everywhere, but there's also a few subtle changes to this version, which is not normal for Plasma. It is mainly stock Plasma, but as you can see, your time here, it looks slightly different, but it's still the same here. And then everything here is still the same. You got your KDE Connect, you don't have your Vault by default installed, you don't have your desktop integration by default installed. You don't have your hamburger menu, but if you right click all your normal options is here. You only got the stock KDE wallpaper background, but if you go to your system settings, you will immediately notice that you don't have Discover, you got the very good Solus Software Center, and yeah, so it's the exactly same sort Software Center which we all love and know, and you can search here for any app you want, but the third party apps will not appear in your search. You can find them here very simple, there's not too many of them, but it's enough. Chrome, Android Studio, VPS, Viber, Skype, they are all also here, which you can easily install, and if you don't want them, you can just go for the normal install, and that's very cool. Settings is also here, so you can automatic check for updates, and all these options you can configure here. If you go to the main system settings, it's exactly the same as KDE. Themes. There's a few missing features. So they only got Breeze at the moment. They don't have their own version look and feel yet. But I'm not sure if they're gonna even get something like that. They don't have a white theme for the pointers, only a black theme. So there's a few things different, but it's minor things. If you go to the info center, so you can see it's very much a KDE version because it's the first release, but it's all based on Solus, which is really, really cool. So as you can see, Solus 3.9999, KDE Plasma 5.14.1, so it's the latest, and you have kernel 4.18, so it's really 0.14, so it's up to date. And if you go to the, and they use the file manager Dolphin, you will see that there's still a few bugs here and there, but it's minor things. As you can see, YARP is not working, so you will run into a few bugs on the way because it is a development edition, but it's so cool that it's actually here. And Office, they got LibreOffice, just the free, they don't have all the rest of the apps, so they just got the three main ones. Office, Spreadsheet, and Presentation. Yes, so it's a really cool release. It's nothing super new, but the main thing of this release is Solus got now a KDE Plasma person which they are busy working on. And that is exciting because you know they always do something great when they take something on, and I can't wait to see the future of this release. This is version 1. They threw Plasma on, they added some of the apps, and I can't wait to see where this project is going. Yeah, so thank you for watching, see you later, goodbye.